chers amis, bonsoir et bienvenue à cet nouvel épisode de Franglish présenté par EduCreator. Hello everyone, today we are going to do project. The project's title is Les Pays Francophones or Le Monde Francophone, which means in English, French-speaking countries or French-speaking world. De commencer, abonnez-vous à ma chaîne pour voir plus de vidéos. Subscribe to my channel to watch more videos. I have divided this video into three main parts. Part 1 is introduction of the French speaking world. In French is introduction du monde francophone. Part 2 is the preparation of the project, la préparation du projet. Part 3 is the content and presentation, which means le contenu du projet et la présentation. Before I start with the three parts, I just want to explain what does francophone mean. Francophone means French speaker. So any language that has phon in it, that means that language speaker. For English speakers in French, we call them anglophone. For Arabic speakers, we call them arabophone. For Spanish speakers, we call them hispanophone. So French speakers, we call them francophone. Let's start now by the first part, which is introduction to the French speaking world. Introduction du monde francophone. So French is an official language or one of the official languages of 33 countries in the world, which makes it second after English with 45 countries. French also is the only language that is taught in every country in the world. French is an official language in these countries. What does an official language mean? Okay? An official language means that the language is the language of education, administration, and government. And also, it's the language that is spoken by most of the population in that country. It is also an official language in these French territories. I put all of them here, guys, for you in the list so you can see them. And French is an official language with one or more other official languages in these countries. Look to the list and you will notice there are many countries that we already know that they have more than one official language, like Canada, like Belgium, Switzerland. So these countries, they have more than one official language. This last list, guys, contains the countries where French is not an official language, but it has an important role. It can be in school, it can be in administration, it can be in government. I'll give you an example. In Algeria, French is not the official language, but French is used in administration, is used at school, especially with higher education in universities. Let's go to the second part now. The second part is project preparation, la préparation du projet, okay? So, students here, you will need to use Google Slides or PowerPoint to do this project. There are some teachers who ask their students to do a poster, but in this video, I am going to talk how to do this project in Google Slides or in a PowerPoint. So, for this project, guys, we will need 10 slides, okay? So we need to use 10 slides, okay? So now we are going to say what we need to put in each slide. We will go from slide 1 all the way to slide 10. Let's go to slide 1 now. I have noticed something with our students. They always like to put in the first slide a shining picture with the title of the project, and they put by and they put their name beside it. We don't want to do that, okay? So in slide 1, you put the introduction of yourself. So slide 1 is going to be your information with your picture. Slide 2, you put the name of the country, you put the location and the capital. Slide 3 now, you are going to put the flag with the flag presentation and the population. Slide 4, you are going to talk about clothes in this country. Slide 5, you are going to talk about food in this country. Slide 6, you are going to talk about sport in that country. And slide 7, you are going to talk about famous places in that country. In slide 8, you will talk about famous people from that country. They can be athletes, actors, or singers. The last two slides, 9 and 10, for 9, you give your own opinion about this country, and slide 10, you put the relationship between United States and this country. This project has to be all done in French, okay? So, which means it has to be written in French and presented in French. No English in the project. Let's go to the last part of the video now, which is the content of the project, le contenu du projet. In this part also, we are going to follow the slides. So I will tell you exactly what you need to write in each slide. All the sentences must be written in French, okay? Use simple sentences, use simple verbs, so you will be able to present the project easily. So in slide 1, like I told you, you will put your information. So you will put your picture and you will put your name, your age, and which school you're going to. Exactly like in this picture. In slide 2, you will put the name of the country, the location of the country, and the capital, okay? Exactly like in the picture. So for the name, you can just build it as a sentence by saying, today I am going to talk to you about, and you put the name of the country. For example, you say, aujourd'hui, je vais vous parler de la France. Today, I am going to talk to you about France. Aujourd'hui, je vais vous parler du Canada. Today, I am going to talk to you about Canada. For the location also, keep it very simple. So you say, for example, Canada is located in North America. And that's it. And of course, you illustrate with a picture of a map of America, for example, to show that this is Canada and this is the location of Canada in America. For the capital also, you need to keep it simple by just writing a very simple sentence, one line. You just say, the capital of France is Paris. So you say, the capital of, the name of the country, is plus the capital. La capitale de la France est Paris. La capitale de la Belgique est Bruxelles. So remember, in this slide 2, you will need to write only 3 sentences, okay? So sentence 1, you say the name of the country. Sentence 2, the location. And then the capital. And you must put a picture, okay? So you need to put the picture of the map. Let's go to slide 3 now. Slide 3 is very simple. Here you will put the picture of the flag of that country and you will write 2 sentences. One sentence, to say the colors of the flag, you do not present the colors. You do not say what each color mean. You just say the colors of the flag of this country are, and you put the colors. For example, you say, les couleurs du drapeau de la France sont rouge, bleu et blanc. The colors of the French flag are red, blue and white. And for the population, you just need to put the round number. You don't have to put what's behind the point, okay? For example, if the population of Belgium is 11 point some million, you don't worry about the point some, you just worry about 11. So you will say the population of Belgium is around 11 million. La population de la Belgique est d'environ 11 millions. So slide 3, only 2 sentences with 1 picture of the flag. Slide 4, now you will talk about clothes, okay? So here you will write 2 or 3 sentences just talking about clothes in general in that country. For example, if you talk about clothes in Canada, you can say something like they wear big coats because it's very cold. They also wear boots because it snows all the time. You can also include some clothes that they wear in holidays or festivals. And also in this slide, don't forget to illustrate with pictures, okay? So you can put pictures of people and what they're wearing in those countries. In slide 5, you will talk about food, okay? So in this slide, you will just talk about the most famous food in that country in one or two sentences. And also, you will put pictures of that food. Slide 6 now. Slide 6 is sports, okay? Here also, you will talk about sports in general in that country, okay? Then you will talk about the most played sport in that country, okay? So you can say France is famous by le cyclisme, but the most famous sport is le football. And you can even include stuff like they won the World Cup twice by putting pictures of the players, of the national team, or any other famous athlete. In slide 7, you will write also a couple sentences about famous places to visit in that country. For example, if you're talking about France, you talk about the Eiffel Tower. And also, don't forget to put pictures of those famous places. In slide number 8 now, you will talk about famous people from that country. You can list one or two people, okay? They can be athletes, they can be singers, they can be actors, okay? By putting their names and their pictures. Slide number 9 now, you will just write your own opinion. How do you like this country, or what do you think about this country? You can write something like, I like this country because I really want to go visit it. I like their language, their people. You can even say, I like their food. I like to visit their famous places and more. In the last slide now, slide number 10, you will just talk about the relationship between United States and that country, okay? So in this one, guys, you can just put a picture of the two flags or the two presidents shaking hands or something, and you will just write a couple sentences talking about the relationship between these two countries. It can be economic or government. The students will have 2 weeks to do this project, okay? So teachers, you should give 2 chances for the students to work while you are there watching them, so you can be there and help them or give them some tips in preparing the project. Try to finish the project 2 or 3 days before the due date so you can prepare or you can practice for the presentation. That's it for today. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel to watch more videos. Merci de suivre avec nous. J'espère que vous avez aimé la vidéo. N'oubliez pas de vous abonner à ma chaîne. Au revoir et à la prochaine.